Heavy cloud and confusion could be to blame for one of Victoria's worst aviation accidents in more than 30 years. A preliminary air safety report has detailed the chopper's final moments before it crashed at Mount Disappointment, killing all five on board.
Memories and photos are all Andrew has left of his sister Linda.
That we're still numb. There's still some disbelief.
A female trailblazer in agriculture, she was the glue to the Woodford family.
We're terribly missing her and she had an incredible laugh. Everyone comments about Linda's amazingly loud laugh, so we're never going to hear that again.
On the 31st of March, Linda died alongside passengers Paul Trozier, Ian Perry and Nicholas Vasudeva. At the aircraft's helm was 32-year-old pilot Dean Neal. It was one of two helicopters which had picked up passengers from Batman Park for a business trip to Alupna in the state's north.
As they approached Mount Disappointment, the pilot of the first helicopter, some 3 kilometres ahead of the second, reported entering increasing cloud cover.
The preliminary report details confusion between the pilots, the other pilot telling Dean to turn around, broadcasting U-turn, U-turn, U-turn. Dean radioed back with words to the effect of, "Aren't we going to cut through?" A passenger then saw the doomed chopper pass below them. They lost all visibility. It was like a whiteout.
It was almost like they were trapping themselves into a corner.
Peeking through the bleached ghost gums of Mount Disappointment, the wreck of the microflight aircraft. Most of the wreckage was destroyed in a fire, but investigators found no evidence of any defects that could have caused the crash. Microflight says in a statement its thoughts are with the loved ones and families of those impacted by this terrible tragedy. Investigators are yet to pinpoint the exact cause. The final report could still be many months away.
Lessons can be learned and maybe that can go up to the aviation industry so that no other family has to go through what we have.
Rebecca Powell for 10 News First.